My question is, what are your thoughts on Ed, the booty man, Leslie Beefcake? He's recently been really eccentric, unfollowing and refollowing Hogan on Twitter, going apeshit over Hogan not wishing him a happy birthday, and randomly ranting on how he didn't ride Hogan's coattails to stay relevant, or try to stay relevant. I recall a story where he shut down the entire Boston subway system when cocaine was mistaken for anthrax a few years back. What are your thoughts on the talent, the life... It is a bit insane shutting down the whole subway.
Would this have been the first time that anybody in history was relieved to find out that something was cocaine that they were possessing instead of
you would think so. Let me just finish the question. Yeah, what are your thoughts on the talent, the life, and the mania that is Brother Brutus? By the way, love the kayfabe commentary's recent shoot tape, Richie.
Thank you, Richie. You know, first of all, I've not spent a lot of time with Brutus Beefcake. I met him and the Hulk when they came to Tennessee in 1979. They were both rookies, and we've talked about it. They were rotten. They were just rotten. You could tell that Hogan could talk a little bit, but they were both rotten in the ring. And then I've never been in the same place as either one of them. I saw him last year, Beefcake, at I believe it was either Scarefest or the Lexington Comic Convention. And I've never had any issues with him. I don't know that he'll go down in the pantheon of all-time great workers, but I didn't know that he was following and unfollowing. I didn't know he shut the fucking subway system down. I didn't know about it. Maybe I should investigate more. Somebody, we need to hire an investigative journalist to find out more about Brutus Beefcake, Booty Man, Ed Leslie, Dizzy Hogan.
Indeed. This is one of those, we'll get an intern. This is one of those gimmicks where somebody had explained it to me before I saw it. They said, oh yeah, there's this guy, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. I was like, all right, what's that all about? Well, he has these garden shears and he's got tights that have like big cutouts on the sides. You're seeing a lot of hip. I'm like, then he does what exactly? Well, he just kind of hangs out with his shears. And does he actually cut people's hair? Not really.
Yes, they had a deal. That's how he got that gimmick. And forgive me, folks. I did not watch the WWF. I made mention of this. I didn't watch it, so I don't know what happened. But he had a hair match with one guy and cut his hair, and then forevermore referred to himself as Brutus the Barber. And I don't know who that person was that got their hair cut. And I don't. Maybe somebody can write and fill us in if they are so inclined.
And then we have to be so inclined to read that.
I got to be honest with you. After, you know, after the early 80s, my WWF history has a big hole in it till about 94, 3 or 4 when I got there. So I got a 10-year period where I didn't really see any of the stuff, and I don't have it on instant memory command.